Bismillahi ar-Rahmani ar-Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mu'minun in Juz 18, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that the believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those people who have iman has succeeded. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically speaks about those people who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a way that their iman are the reason wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter them into paradise. The surah goes on to describe various qualities of the believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, they are just, they are trustworthy, they pay their zakah, they do what they have promised others. However, the surah then speaks specifically to those people where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ, those people who are punctual and who makes their salah regardless of anything. حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَوَاتِ الْوُسْطَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to make our salah and to not ever let our salah go. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same surah describes those people while being in their salah. And where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, while they are in their salah, they are in the salah in a state of consciousness and fear for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are not just standing and doing actions. However, their hearts are present. Their minds are present. They are focused. They are looking down and they are praying to the one and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah, who is the best of examples, he taught us with the companions that reported that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made salah in such a way that he was like an oud in the ground. He never moved, he never did anything, he was only focused on pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he made salah in such a way that his ankles would crack out of the length of his salah. The sahaba then, they asked Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, why is it so that you make so long salah and so much sujood and so much dua and you are so present within your salah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already ordained that he will be entered into paradise. Yet he answered and he said, أَفَلَا أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا, should I then not be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is thankful for the favors and the bounties and the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon him? We learn from this that within our Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with, how and what is the situation of our salah? How is our presence within our salah? Are we present? Are we really present within our salah, or are we merely just doing the actions because we must? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us punctual on our salah and to make us present within it and to make us of those who are true believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ, those people who are true believers, they will be rewarded with what? الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ, they will be rewarded with the highest ranks in Jannah, Jannatul Firdaus, whom fiha khalidun, and they will be in it for eternal and everlasting. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and grant us understanding. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.